Dreaming of your wedding or getting married. Hi everyone, I hope you well. Now, this interpretation of the dream is for people who are in a marriage or people who are in a relationship, okay? This interpretation applies to people who are married or in a relationship. This is where you see yourself getting married again and again and again. In some dreams, the spouse appears. In other dreams, the spouse doesn't appear, but you're getting married. Okay? It's just a wedding. In this dream, the marriage preparation is, they're just going well. Everything is perfect. And then in the other one, things are just messed up. But you're just always getting married. In this dream, you're happy. In this dream, you're not so happy. In this dream, things are going according to plan. In this other dream, things were just going south. Now, what does that mean? First, let's start by covering our bases. You want to pray against a spiritual spouse. You want to cancel. You want to break that spirit over you. We're just covering bases here. And once that is done, once that is out of the way, once you have cut the links with you and the spiritual spouse, once you have cursed the root of that spiritual spouse, wherever it's coming from, wherever it's stemming from, then we can move on to the next thing, okay? We're just covering bases here. It's good to be practical when solving problems, but it doesn't hurt to first start with the spiritual cleaning and just make sure that things are in order there. Once that is out, second thing, which I believe this is actually the thing, the reason you're probably see yourself getting married again and again, it just means that you are very unhappy in this relationship or you're very unhappy in this marriage. When this is for you, it will make sense to you. It will reason, like a spirit will testify to this. You are unhappy in the relationship. If you are unhappy in this relationship, chances are you are going to have dreams like that. If you are unhappy in your marriage, chances are you will have recurring dreams of you getting married again and again. So what's the solution? Well, we've already prayed about the spiritual spouse, if that's the case. But now, the practical side of it. Now let us look. If you're not married to this person, it's a good time for you to literally just take a step back. You literally have to take a step back, take a break, get back to yourself, find yourself. Have that time with the Lord. It's not time for you to leave this person and go to the next. Ask for space. And in the space, you want to be by yourself and find yourself. Because when you are in a toxic relationship, it's not easy to see how toxic the person is up until there is a separation. Okay? And you have to be strong to resist going back in that separation. Because the longer you stay away from a toxic relationship, the more you're able to pick up the severity of it and how it was damaging to you. What business do you have getting married to such a person? What business do you have? Hallelujah. Another thing, if you are married and you see yourself getting married again and again and again, okay? Especially if it's the same person. But then like I said, the person does not necessarily have to be in a dream, but you know that you're just getting married again and again. It's a wedding. It's always a wedding. You're always getting married. All it means is you were just unhappy in this marriage. Things aren't right in this marriage. The Lord needs to intervene. And it will make me even wonder, like with you dealing with this man, you dealing with this woman, did you ever ask the Lord if this is the person? During your dating, during your courting, did you involve God or was even the courting sinful? Like you need to sit back and understand, where did you get this person? How did you get this person? How did you people get started? Hallelujah. Is this person even your wife? Is this person even your husband? What is not of the Lord will bring you stress. It will bring you strife. It will bring you misery. It will bring you unhappiness. You will never be at peace. We associate peace and love with God, and anything else That is not in line with that. We need to wonder and ask ourselves if we are in the will of God. You can be in the right marriage with an ordained spouse, and in whatever you go through, it doesn't matter how hard the situation is, but when you are in God, when it is ordained of the Lord, there will be that peace. You'll be able to go through the fire with the person, but there will be that peace. Hallelujah. It's like if the job is ordained as yours, doesn't matter that the challenges you go through, like there will be that peace because it's yours, it's ordained. Like there is God in it. As we live our lives and we cancel God out of things, then things won't go well. For the longest of time, we've always done things our way. Perhaps we include the God in certain areas, but when it comes to things like relationships, that's when we like kick him to the curb, or we just put him in the corner and tell him to wait. We'll attend to him. We're just busy trying to sort out our relationship. The Lord wants to be involved in every area of our lives. Hallelujah. So yes, if you dream yourself being married again and again and again, you're always getting married. It's always your wedding. Whether it's a good one or a bad one, whether you wake up feeling happy or you wake up feeling sad, it's a recurring dream. And this will carry on if you're in a relationship for those of you who stay in relationship for 3 years, it will carry on for those 3 years. And for those of you who are in a marriage, it will continue on with you in that marriage. Hallelujah. Yeah. I don't even want to get started on the women who are in those prolonged relationships, which are sinful. Okay. Because also as women, we play a big part, a significant part in prolonging that process by sleeping with a man. That is why everything needs to be done according to the word. The word of the Lord protects us. It protects us. Hallelujah. It protects us. And with this kind of culture that we live in, this culture is not just damaging to the women. It's also damaging to the men. And my prayer is that also the men wake up to the fact that it is not just the women who wake up feeling empty and broken and used. But so does man, and be able to make change. It's not about changing the world, really. It's about changing yourself. As long as you can get your own life in order and have that peace, and have that peace in God, that's all. And your own life will testify, and it will be that walking testimony for someone. Hallelujah. Yeah, thank you, guys. That's all I wanted to share. God bless.